Welcome, everyone. I'm Terry Ray, Children's Minister at the Westport Road Church of Christ. I'm so glad you've joined us today. Well, kids, with school right around the corner, I want to help you get those brain cells fired up and ready to go. So we're going to play a little game, a problem-solving game, answering a few riddles. I'm going to read a riddle. Your job is to solve it, and you, if you know the answer, just shout it out. Here's the first one. I have four legs, but I can't walk. What am I? You're right. A chair or a table, either one. Second riddle. I'm usually green and brown. Birds like to build a nest in me. Children like to climb me. What am I? Oh, you're right. A tree. Good for you. Okay. Third riddle. I always come in a pair. That's two. You may need to tie me and untie me. You wear me outside, but you take me off before you go swimming. What am I? And the answer is shoes. You're right. Last one. I have buttons or a zipper and occasionally a belt. You wear me in the winter to keep warm. You don't need me in the summer. What am I? That's right. A coat. Very good. Good thinking, kids. God made people able to think and solve problems. Sometimes problems are fun, like answering a riddle or solving a puzzle. But most of the time, problems are not fun at all. Have you ever had a problem with a friend or a family member? Well, all families disagree sometimes, but God wants families to cooperate and find a solution. God doesn't want family members to argue. Family members can work out differences. That's right. Family members can work out differences. When family members work together, they honor God. Today's Bible verse reminds us to do our part to live in peace with others. Let's read it together. Do your best to live in peace with everyone. Romans 12:18. What an important verse. Choosing to live at peace with others can be difficult. Sometimes it's hard to cooperate and be kind, especially when you're hurt or angry. But God wants us to choose peace, especially with our family members. Today, the Mitchell family has put together a wonderful skit to teach us that family members can work out differences.
Do I want you to talk to me now? I said I was sorry. What more can I do? Jordan, are we cousins? Why are you treating me this way?
Of course we're cousins, and I. Why would you even ask that question?
Well, family members work things out, Jordan. They don't ignore each other.
Yeah, you're right. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, too. I didn't mean to hurt your feelings. Honestly, I was only kidding.
It's okay. If I had blown up at you and gotten angry, none of this would ever happen.
So how do we fix this mess? I don't want you to be mad at me forever.
I forgive you. Will you forgive me?
Yes, I forgive you, too.
Glad that's okay.
Me too.
I was wondering why people argue sometimes at night. I don't like to argue.
I don't know, Jordan. It's probably because they're too busy thinking about themselves instead of others.
What do you mean?
Well, if I had stopped and think about how I made you feel on my words, then I would have had said them.
And if I had just talked to you and not get angry, none of this would have ever happened.
Do you remember our Bible lesson last week? Mr. Ron and Miss Kathy said Jesus put needs over others before his own.
I do remember, and I guess I should start following Jesus' example more.
I know sometimes I need to do better at solving problems and getting along, but it's hard.
And I think Jesus just wants me to keep trying sometimes.
Jordan, I'm glad we had this talk.
I am too. Hey, you want to go check out the new video games and animals?
Sounds good. Let's go.
Excellent job, kids. Solving problems isn't easy, but the Bible said that God will help us. In James 1:5, the Bible tells us that we can ask God for wisdom, and he will give it to us. And wisdom is so helpful when solving problems. Today's Bible story comes from the book of Genesis. You know, the very first book of the Bible, it's in the Old Testament. Adam and Eve have since left the Garden of Eden to raise their family. Noah and his family were the chosen family to survive the flood. And in our story today, Abram is a descendant of Noah. Abram is called to take his family to a new land. So Abram obeyed God and took his entire family and his nephew Lot. A quarrel arose among the herdsmen of Abram and Lot. Well, Abram was determined that family members can work out differences. Let's see how Abram brought peace to his family.
The time had come for Abram to leave Egypt. At this time, Abram was rich in livestock, silver, and gold. He took all that he owned, along with his wife Sarai and his nephew Lot. Lot also had flocks, herds, and tents. As they traveled, the herdsmen of Abram's livestock and the herdsmen of Lot's livestock began to quarrel. There was not enough land to support all of Abram and Lot's cattle and possessions. Abram told Lot, "We are relatives. Please, let's not argue. Look at all the land right before us. Let's separate. If you go to the left, I will go to the right. And if you go to the right, I will go to the left." Lot looked out and saw that the Jordan Valley was well watered. It reminded him of the land they left in Egypt. So Lot chose the Jordan Valley for himself. He journeyed eastward and set up his tent near the city of Sodom. I guess the grass is always greener on the other side. Abram went toward the land of Canaan. Then the Lord said to him, "Look at the land to the north, south, east, and west. I will make your family so large, you won't be able to count your offspring. They will be like the dust of the earth. Get up and walk the length and width of the land, for I will give all of it to you and your family." Abram trusted God. Abram moved his tent and cattle and servants to the land, and there he built an altar to the Lord.
Abram did not want his family to argue. So Abram gave Lot his choice of land so that they could live in peace. In the end, God blessed Abram with even more land and the promise of a large family. Family members can work out differences, and God blessed Abram for solving the herdsman's quarrel. You know, Jesus taught that people should be peacemakers. Jesus showed us over and over again how to solve problems and love each other, especially our family members. Boys and girls, it has been several months since we've seen each other, and I sure have missed your faces. Let's take a look at the smiling faces in our summer fun video. goodness, what great pictures. Thanks for sending them in, and I look so forward to seeing you soon. The children from Mooseberry Academy are back in school now. Lannis and Tannis are in the middle of a quarrel. I'm wondering if they can work out their differences and solve their problems and make peace. Let's watch our video now.
Not that I care or whatever, but Lannis and his twin brother Tannis do not get along.
Lannis will never be the genius that I am. I'm plenty genius. More geniuser than Tannis. Plus, I don't have a fake British accent. He was born in Ohio.
These are the chronicles of the Mooseberry Masterclass and the exceptional and very, very, very gifted students who attend, and also Alex.
With my extracurricular activities, I'm a more well-rounded student than Lannis. Well, I'm more socially aware, so I'm a more well-rounded person.
Kablammo! I've jumped my bike through a ring of fire and tiptoed through a snake pit. But listening to you two has become my most dangerous stunt.
Yeah, they need to figure it out. Or don't. I don't care.
The best way to solve this once and for all is with a competition.
Yeah, see who can swim with sharks the longest. My record is 1 second.
Maybe they're onto something. I'd be open to a competition. Not the shark thing though, that's a terrible idea. What do you expect? That amateur stuntman isn't a genius.
It's your man Ollie on the street with a series of head-to-head brotherly competition for the ages. First competition, holding their breath. 3, 2, 1, go.
He cheated! The contest was to hold our breath. It didn't specify where we held it.
Second competition, staring contest. 3, 2, 1, go.
Really? Fake teeth? Have we stooped so low? There was no rule against it.
We're all tied up, sports fans. It all comes down to this. It's time to see who can swim with sharks the longest.
No way. No way. No way. I grow weary of this. I'm clearly superior. If that's so, then why are we tied?
Enough! This isn't helping anything. I think you two are going about this the wrong way. Family members should be able to work out differences regardless of what the differences are. And the only sure way to resolve your issues is by taking them to God. He can give the guidance and the wisdom that you need. He's been helping people since the beginning of the world.
I think God will want us to stop arguing over something silly and trying to prove who's better. Well, maybe I'll prove it by leaping in the shark tank after all. Cannonball! That's my brother.
Kablammo! He broke my record!
Kids, do your best to live in peace with everyone. God wants you to work out differences. This week, choose not to argue with your brothers or sister or parents. Work together to find a solution. Follow Jesus' example to live in peace. Please join me in a closing prayer. God, we love you. Thank you for our families. Please help us to be kind and live at peace with others. When we have differences, please help us find good solutions and act in ways that honor you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Parents, kids, check out the online resources in today's lesson. The resources include activity pages, Bible story video, family conversations, prayer guide, and Mooseberry life action video. Access the link to the Lifeway website on the weekly church email, and also on the church's Facebook page. click on the link, which will take you to a login page. Choose either preschool materials or elementary school age materials. Thanks for joining us today. I hope you've enjoyed our time together. Blessings to all, and please wash your hands.